Hi, Stefano Rivella here, the chair of GTV. I'd like to introduce this program to you, and I'd like to make also a few presentations about some of the members and the students working on helping us in running this program. So I'm the chair, Stefano Rivella, and the vice chair is Denise Sabatino. The chair admission committee is Catherine Barr. And the GTV administration person is Anna Klein. The student leaders are Laura Paul, Kelly Fagan, and Mackenzie Collins. Although there are a variety of additional students have been very helpful and contributing to the development of our program. For instance, while Laura Hall is also involved in the overall program of GTV for the second year students, Jesse Weber, Catherine Hawkins are also helping with the first year students, Mackenzie Collins, the fourth year, Kylie Conrad for the transition from the first to second year in the Journal Club. But there are also additional roles and initiatives that we'll discuss later on. So there are additional resources that you can definitely look at, such as the GTV Peer Mentoring folder and the website where you can find more information about the activities and the faculties related to GTV. So I wanted also to mention a few things about the science of GTV. It's a very exciting program, which is really a combination of a variety of technologies that really can be they were considered translational in the sense that take the basic science and trying to use new tools and drugs to modify and improve the life of patients. We have a variety of tools as listed here. You can see a variety of vectors such as Lenti, AAV, and Adeno utilized for gene transfer. Genome editing is also an important player in this kind of tools, but there are also interesting different directions such as vector design, since although vectors have been utilized for doing gene transfer or to deliver tools that can lead to genome editing, their modification can really expand the targets and organs of the places where this treatment can be utilized. Of course, we're also talking about cellular therapies because for instance, CAR T technology is not just a modification of a function on sequence of DNA, but also manipulation of cells. And also, I like also to stress and underline there are a variety of additional tools, such as shRNA or antisense oligonucleotides, that became very popular and being utilized right now for the treatment of a variety of disorders. Saying that, as you probably will investigate and see from the website, there are a variety of targets in our program in the sense that, the variety of diseases that people are trying to correct or cure. And here I listed some of them from solid cancer to coagulation defect, red cell disorders, and many more. So I also want to highlight a few of our faculties that are being very successful or leading the field for a variety of manifestations. For instance, Dr. Bennett has been a pioneer in the gene therapy field. Here, just to remind you that her study eventually led to one of the first products that was approved by the FDA for gene therapy in the United States for the correction of Leber's congenital amaurosis, which is a severe defect in vision defect. And the replacement of the gene RPE65. Addition to the retina of these children can restore their vision. And the product now is available to this patient under the name of Luxturna. We have also a really large number also of people working in the CAR T field, which is extremely popular among the students right now. And obviously we have Carjun, who is a pioneer in the definition of the concept of CAR T and the development of tools. And again, in collaboration with Dr. Group, Dr. Graf has been able to bring one of the first, the, basically the first gene therapy prodrug to for some of these treatments in leukemia. And but there are a variety of additional excellent labs where people normally rotate or eventually end up doing their thesis, such as the lab of Dr. Gill, Dr. Milone, and Dr. Mellanhorst. There are also additional targets. For instance, hemophilia is an important disease. It's been studied at Penn and CHOP for many years. Now, some of the leaders in this field are Dr. Ruda and Dr. Sabatino, who's the vice chair of GTV. And they've been using primarily AAV vectors and modification of the genes to increase the activity of activity of the vector, but also the transgene to modify and improve hemophilia in many patients. In addition, we also, you know, GTV also includes the world vaccine, and this is also a very important element in our program, being led by pioneers in the field, such as Dr. Weiner, and in collaboration with the Wistar Institute. Many vaccines have been developed here in our institutions, and there's still a strong tradition in going that direction. As you can imagine, many studies right now are focusing on also COVID-19. And so this is obviously not an emerging field, but they're very active and with promises in many directions, not only for infectious diseases, but also for cancer. There are also additional studies. For instance, Dr. Curry is an example, is an excellent faculty in GTV who works on modification of the hematopoietic stem cells with an antiviral vector for the cure, focusing mostly on the cure of bone marrow failures. And the origin and the manipulation of stem cells and their development during disease progression. Obviously, here it's a very brief overview how potentially the basic science and the vectorology can be combined together to induce or to transduce a curative gene in the hematopoietic stem cells and infusing the patient to correct their disease. So obviously, we also have a variety of exciting things here in the GTV program. We have GTV Research in Progress talks. And this year, we also include, I'm going to include a rotation presentation after the students spend some time in a few labs. They can really have a chance to discuss their experience and their science during that time. Laura Hall is also leading the so-called GT Vectors on GTV Mentoring Program, which is a peer support program for the first and second year students, and including many students, older students that will help the younger student to navigate the system. Mackenzie will also introduce you to what we call the GTV Happy Hours, which is a bi-monthly get-togethers to meet up with students, colleagues, and to discuss and ask questions. And also other activities such as GTV Ski Trip, and Kelly Fagan will lead that effort. We also have a variety of faculties can help the student, especially the young student, to navigate different laboratories for a variety of topics. These also listed here. They are listed already in the website, so I'm not going to read the full list. But basically, these are resources and faculties that you can contact to really understand more about the variety of laboratory working on gene transfer, immunology, vaccine, and cell therapies. And of course, keep in mind also we have a close relationship with the MPV program, NCB, where you are also free to rotate and eventually do your thesis. And finally, I won't here put a face on the names, some of the main names I mentioned so far. Mackenzie Collins, Laura Hall, and Kelly Fagan are very active students in the GTV program, and I'm sure they will be in contact with you and providing you many wonderful resources and information for your experience at GTV. Thank you so much, and I finish here my presentation.